Hey guys, I'm here today to answer some of the most frequently asked questions on YouTube regarding AI art. Does AI art steal art? What can AI art be used for? Stick around as I demystify AI art. What can AI art do? AI art allows you to create digital artwork with just an AI art generator and an idea. Nowadays, it can refer to anything from images to audio and video. You just have to input a prompt like, a girl who looks like the Statue of Liberty in the style of pop art. And the AI generator will give you what you're looking for. The more detailed you are with your prompt, the better your results will be. What can AI art be used for? AI art can be used for many things. It makes the process of creating storyboards and concept designs more efficient, and it can create image aids for presentations if you can't find anything to suit your specifications, among other things. Does AI art steal art? This is a very controversial topic. AI art engines are trained using existing art, however, the art that it generates is different from any existing work. The program is not cutting and pasting images it finds, rather, it looks at what it thinks is relevant to the prompt you've typed and gives you an output based on an amalgamation of information. I'd say it's similar to all artists who study other artists and go on to create something of their own. How to make AI art. To make AI art, all you need is an AI image generator and a prompt. PowerDirector's AI text-to-image tool has a text box that'll allow you to prompt anything from your imagination. Pick if you want either a portrait or scenery, and select a style. Click Generate Images and let the AI do the rest. For part two of this video, we will delve deeper and answer questions related to AI video editing. Stay tuned for our next video and remember to subscribe. Welcome back to our Q&A section where you ask and we answer.
Referring to our AI anime video feature, @historiosaramavas asks, is there a video size limit to be able to use this effect?
The limit to use this effect is a 10, 20, or at most a 30-second clip. If you want to process a longer video, I'd suggest breaking your long video into shorter clips and processing them individually. Each processed clip requires a certain number of credits. A certain number of credits will be provided to you every month if you've got a subscription to PowerDirector, and if they aren't enough, you can purchase more.
@sunshine427 asks, how can I make a voiceover? Can't find it anymore since the new update.
In PowerDirector for PC, the voiceover button can be found in the Media tab in the Record option. Hope that helps. Stay tuned for part two of this video and subscribe to keep up to date. Or if you have any more questions, leave them in the comments below.